God.
Oh my god, guys, welcome to another video in which we're going to be tackling the topic of rotational symmetry. So in today's video, we're basically going to be taking a look at the concept of rotational symmetry and some examples on when do we actually have rotational symmetry and what does it actually mean. So let's begin. Okay, guys, so the first thing we're going to be taking a look, of course, is this concept, right? So a figure that maps onto itself when it is rotated around its center by an angle measuring less than 360 degrees has rotational symmetry, right? So in other words, whenever we rotate an image, right, and it ends up in a position that is like the initial one, right? So it's going to be the exact same thing, or it looks like it's going to be the exact same thing. It's going to have rotational symmetry. Right. Now we're going to take a quick look at some examples of rotational symmetry. Right. So identify if there is rotational symmetry on each one of these images. Right. So on the first one, right, we have a rectangle, and we see that when we rotate it 90 degrees, it's actually not going to look in any way, right? So let's say we have point A here. Now point A is going to be here. But let's say we rotate it once again 90 degrees, making it a total of 180 degrees. Now we have point A right here. But it doesn't really matter that point A is not exactly in the same position as it was initially. The image looks exactly the same. And because of that, we know that the first image is going to have rotational symmetry. Now let's take a look at the star. In the case of the star, let's say that the tip of the star is going to be called point A. Let's say we rotate it a little bit, right? And now point A is going to be right here. But we rotate it a little bit more, and then point A is going to be right here. Now, as you can see, there's actually five more movements that I can do, and the point A is going to be end up in this position, or in this position. And it doesn't really matter. The start is kind of the same. It looks exactly in the same position, right? It doesn't look tilted like in these two cases, because I am just adjusting the angle, right? So whenever I'm doing that, I can say that the star indeed has rotational symmetry because there are some angles which I can rotate it to that are going to give us the exact same result like it was in the first place. What about the next one, right? So what about that small L we have right there? So when we rotate it, right, we rotate it a little bit, then it's completely horizontal, then it comes, we keep rotating it, and we rotate it, and it doesn't really change, right? So we can continue rotating it, and it's not going to have the same position as it had in the beginning, right? So this image looks nothing like any of those images. So that means that in this case, this one is not going to have rotational symmetry. Now, what do you guys think about a circle, right? It doesn't really matter how you rotate it or where you rotate it, in which clockwise or counterclockwise, the circle is pretty much going to stay the same way, right? So, any given point, if we rotate it in the circle is going to be looking exactly the same. So in the case of the circle, it does have infinite lines of rotational symmetry because it doesn't really matter which angle you actually rotate it to. The circle is going to be looking exactly the same as we had in the beginning. And that's basically the concept of rotational symmetry, guys. Now, try finding some other examples on your daily life and see if those objects have rotational symmetry. And I'll see you guys in the next one. Bye, guys.
Check out these other videos to improve your math skills, and make sure you click that subscribe button to make the community grow. Follow OMathGod in its social media accounts, drop a like, a comment below, and see you on the next one. Bye!